In this video, I want to show a feature that is commonly forgotten about this car, and that is the Mini Connected app. Hello, my name is Ethan, and welcome to Car Creations. I decided today to go for a drive, and while doing so, I came across the app on my phone that prompted me to connect it to my Mini when I got in the car. I am in an amazing part of British Columbia. We're in the Okanagan, and there are some amazing views around here. Come look at this. Look at that view, it's absolutely ridiculous. You hear the birds. Oh, there's a creek running right there. And look at the car, it looks absolutely gorgeous. Right, so let's open this app up on my phone. So when you get to the first screen, it shows the fuel level and the total range you have till empty. Just filled up, so it should be pretty high. It shows your average speed and your average fuel consumption. 7.1 liters per 100 kilometers is pretty good. Shows you last location. If you forget where you parked your car, you click that and it'll lead you right to your car. If you have more than one car, you'll see them listed here. So then we have destinations, show you maps, and this will connect right to the maps on your car. Activity, this shows recent trips, shows you how, and then you can just go. And it'll show you how to get there. Hub. The hub shows all you the apps that you can put on your car. I currently only have Spotify, but you could put on lots of others. You have profile here. So you can reset your password, change your PIN, etc. Build the app. FindMate. This is where you can add the little FindMate tabs to your keys. So say you forget or lost your keys somewhere, you can add them here. And then you have settings. And it gives you permissions so it can import contacts, calendars, etc. from your phone and put it on your Mini. So later I went and connected my car using the VIN, and that enabled a whole bunch of remote features for me. So when you connect it using the VIN, you get added a locking, unlock, brights, horn, ventilate, locate, and all these other different options for your phone. Just want to test a few of them now, and I put a camera in my car so you can see if it works or not. So first of all, let's test the horn. It normally takes a few seconds. I guess. Oh, there we go. Beeped. Let's see if we can try the locking function. And then the brights. I guess if you're away from your car and you want it to turn back on. So if you're away from the car like we are now, you can ventilate now, or you can ventilate in the future. So if you're going to go on a trip, you can be all ready for that. You can click ventilate now, and that will prepare your car if you're going to go on a drive. Let's try that. Confirm. You actually see how the fans would turn on in the car and start the air conditioning. Yeah, and that's pretty much it. You can also go to info here, and it gives you notifications about your car, such as what doors are locked or unlocked or whatever. If you can't remember if you had your sunroof open or not, or your trunk open or whatever, you can check here and it'll tell you. Control messages, so like tire and engine oil is good. I have a service coming up, so it's telling me I need to do brake fluid, engine oil, vehicle check. And then these are all the features that we have here. So, available to the app, we have send destination to vehicle, locking doors, unlocking doors, check door locks, schedule ventilation, honk horn, flash headlights, check fuel level, check fuel range, check mileage. And the only disabled feature is locate your vehicle, which I just don't think is available in North America. Hope that was helpful, and if you liked the video, please give a thumbs up. If you really liked it, please subscribe for plenty more content to come.